Welcome back to Skinny Beats, and welcome if you are new to this channel. Today we're just going to have a quick look at our top gluten-free flours that we use in our kitchen. Now, I do just want to say that I am not affiliated or sponsored with any of the brands I will be highlighting today. These are just the brands that we use the most and we have 100% trust in. First up is flaxseed. Both the flaxseed as a ground meal that can be used as a flour, gluten-free, and also flaxseeds as a just ingredient that you can use in a lot of your baking and sprinkle on any salads that you may be eating. They are just a marvel and I feel often overlooked. To the left, we have some of the flaxseed that is just the whole golden flaxseed. These technically are brown flaxseeds here. And what I have here on the right are the Bob's Red Mill whole ground flaxseed meal. And both are certified organic, both of these brands that I use. Now this one here is Bob's Red Mill, gluten-free. And to the left again is the whole flaxseed, but this one is the brand Anthony's. Again, both of these are certified gluten-free. That means that when you are baking, you can be totally confident that there's no cross-contamination in the packing. They have been tested and are safe to use. Now there are other brands around and I would suggest you have a taste of which ones you like the best, but our favorite are these two brands here. Next, we have Anthony's Premium Teff Flour. Again, gluten-free, vegan, and natural. Yet again, I found that Anthony's batch tested and verified gluten-free has given no problems to my family. And this stuff has been really amazing in our baking. I think you'll find that anything we have with a baked good is likely to have teff flour included. It is very fine. It doesn't act like a normal baking flour. This stuff is amazing. It's very nutty in flavor and it will make your goods a little more dense, not light and fluffy, but it is a totally nutrient packed and it's very, very high in protein. I'm just gonna read the back of this to you because it's got calcium, iron, the fat is really low, but carbohydrates, 34 grams at 11% per serving, and it's got a lot of high fiber, but look at that protein, 6 grams of protein in a quarter cup serving, which is one of the reasons we love using this in our vegetarian and vegan meals, because we know we're gonna get a really good protein kick with this flour. Next up is almond flour. We love almonds and we do not have a nut allergy in our household, so we use this often. Now this is a blanched flour. I know some people prefer to make their own and that can be done. There are quite a few tutorials on how to do that. I've not yet mastered drying the flour after grinding it, but I do like to soak my almonds and blend them, strain them, and then I'll use the damp pulp in baking. But when I don't have that time to do that, I will just nab my flour batch here. And again, this is certified gluten-free. This brand just happens to be Kirkland, which is what my local store offers. They don't offer a whole lot of certified gluten-free flours, but this is one of them. Now we're just gonna turn this packet around so you can see the nutrition information on here. Now, what's really interesting is that the serving is a quarter cup, just like the teff flour. And look at the protein level, it's 6 grams, just like teff. So if you thought that you had to have nut flours and you don't really want to, perhaps your stomach isn't happy with nuts, you can change over to teff and still get that protein kick. Now, back to the almond flour, it has less fiber and it has less carbs in this flour, but it also has some iron, some calcium, some potassium, and just a very little bit, not a whole lot, but just a very little bit of vitamin E. So just 2% of your daily value, not enough to really supplement you for your needs, but it's a beautiful tasting flour. And we often use it in cookies and it gives us a nice texture. It's just delicious. Next we have up some coconut flour. Now I do like Anthony's. As you know, it's certified, it's organic, and it has never let me down. Now coconut flour is interesting. Some people love it, some people hate it. Coconut flour will leave your baking super light and fluffy. It's very, very, very high in fiber. I find that sometimes it just sucks up too much moisture in my baking. And of course, if you don't like the flavor of coconut, you're not going to enjoy using this flour. However, if you love the taste of coconut, you will absolutely adore using this flour. If you don't want it to absorb too much moisture in your baking, then you can sort of add some almond flour, and definitely the coconut mixed with teff, they seem to balance each other out really beautifully. Now, I'm gonna just bring you up on these factoids on the back. 2 tablespoons is 1 serving of this meal. Now, 2 tablespoons is not very much. That's why you do not want to fill your baking with pure coconut flour. You might find it's a little too high in your dietary fiber. You also might find it absorbs too much moisture in your gut while it's trying to digest. Again, it's down to your personal flavor taste and also how your body works with each flour. Next up in our kitchen, we have masa. This is a finely ground corn flour used to make tamales. We like to make a lot of our own corn tortillas. We like the fact that we know it's not cross-contaminated and we can make them as thin or thick as we like. And they just taste amazing when they're fresh. But again, you can also use them to make tamales, which are amazingly delicious. So this one is a gluten-free brand. There is not a whole lot of nutrition in corn flour and masa. There is some calcium, there's some iron, as you can see, and there's 3 grams of protein, which is not bad at all. But use this as a base for some of your cooking and then just fill it with beautiful toppings, highly nutritious things that are just going to make you smile and keep you energized throughout the day. Last and definitely not least is our King Arthur gluten-free measure for measure flour. And we use this in a lot of bread baking, anything that needs a yeasted bread, like a pizza dough or just a nice sourdough, we will use this measure for measure gluten-free flour. Now you do still need to add a few things to it to get that fluffy consistency. Gluten-free baking is tricky. It's certainly a different method than the traditional style. And this flour is fortified, as you can see, with iron, calcium, and vitamin D. I'm just gonna flip this case around so you can see some more of the nutrition facts. You know, this is a blended flour, so it's not something that we, you know, use that often. It's just when we're doing like traditional style baking. It's got rice flour, whole grain brown rice flour, whole sorghum flour, tapioca starch, potato starch, cellulose, xanthan gum, and then your added vitamins to that. Now, You do need to add extra xanthan gum if you want to do a bread. It will help lift it. Some people like to also use eggs or egg whites to get that extra sort of fluffy consistency in their breads. I always find that baking breads with gluten-free flour is such a challenge, but when you master it well. So if you're new to gluten-free baking, keep trying and go for things that are sweet, like these on the back of the recipe, deep, dark, fudgy brownies. Personally, I find these have too much sugar for my palate, and I replace a lot of the sugar with maple syrup, but again, that is very much a personal taste. And there you have it. That's our current use of gluten-free flours in our Skinny Beets kitchen. There are many other gluten-free flours and brands on the market. Which brand do you prefer, and which flour do you prefer using? Is there a flour that you would like to know how to use but don't yet? Let me know in the comments and I will see if I can tackle that for you. In the meantime, happy baking, happy eating, stay safe, keep healthy, and we will see you next time.